Now, there's been a rumor going around ATL that Big Meech allegedly said that Young Jeezy was a snitch. And it's also news going around saying that Young Jeezy said that Big Meech was working for the feds. Now, we're going to go ahead and drop some facts and go down the line and see what can possibly be true and what can possibly be false. We're going to talk about what's real and what's fake, who's real and who's fake. Because if anybody know anything about BMF, y'all know that they was moving heavy loads of narcotics back and forth from Atlanta to California. The operation was so big, it was something that was never seen on a grand scale like this. And at the same time, they wasn't being low-key about it. They was all in the clubs with all of the women, pulling up in all of the newest cars, riding around the city like they was untouchable. And it makes you wonder, if these dudes is dealing with this much weight, how come they felt so free to just be out there in the streets being flashy and showing off their watches and jewelry? Now, all the gangster movies done came out and laid the rules down. All these gangster movies set the foundation on what to do and what not to do, and how your fame can cost you your operation. All the movies that came out about the drug game made it obvious that if you're flashy, you're going to get caught. But BMF was beyond flashy. This man had a billboard over the city that said, "The world is mine." And for Young Jeezy to allegedly come out and say that Big Meech was working for the feds, that make you wonder, could it possibly be true? Because if you're going to be a big time dope dealer, drug smuggler, and you're not concerned about getting caught, 9 times out of 10, you working with somebody on the inside, man. And for Young Jeezy to have a whole rap career flaunting his wealth, telling people how he got his money, what he do for a living, his freaking logo was the snowman. How untouchable can you be? Ain't nobody that stupid to be out there living that type of lifestyle and talking about it on national radios. These dudes was on smack DVDs as if the feds is not watching. It only makes sense to me that they knew the feds was watching. Maybe they were the feds altogether. Now, this ain't no disrespect to Big Meech or the Black Mafia family, because these brothers was making a whole lot of money, but there's nothing to glorify here. I'm not about to sit here and make it seem like they did something noble, or they just something to be proud of, and they decent black folks, and they helped out communities. No, they was selling freaking dope to black people, man. And that's the saddest, sickest thing you could possibly do. It's sort of like being a cornball or a nerd or a herb. It should be shamed within the black community. Because nowadays you see these crackheads out here and they miserable, man. It's sickening seeing these people hooked on dope and seeing these people homeless. But every time somebody say something about Big Meech, they bigging him up like he's Jesus Christ or something like that. People making songs dedicated to this man. I'm pretty sure Meech is a solid dude and everything, but come on now. Come on now. You don't ruin so many families for the bag. And I don't respect that. But it's not about my personal opinion. It's more so about Jeezy allegedly said that this man was the po-po the whole time. Now, that could possibly be true. My man DeMario Love said, yeah, that is weird how everybody went down but Jeezy. Man, look, it's weird that everybody was involved with this man the way they was involved with this man and felt so free to have a relationship with a well-known D-boy. You figure if you a celebrity or if you somebody with some power, even if you an average Joe, you don't want to get caught out there with Meech and the whole BMF. But what if the reason everybody felt so comfortable with Big Meech is because he was the feds all along? Now, I know this is dangerous talk. I know this ain't no laughing matter. These are some real heavy dudes in the streets. These dudes do not play no games. I'm not trying to pick a fight with any of these guys, but we gonna have to be real, y'all. If you moving weight and if you doing illegal activities in 2019 or throughout the 2000s, the 90s, even the 80s in some instances, they know what you doing. The technology is too advanced for anybody to have secrets. Ain't no way you gonna keep something on the low when you got an iPhone. Ain't no way you gonna have a secret organization going on when you got an Instagram or a Facebook. And all of these quote unquote D-boys is on social media. How the hell can you get away with selling anything in the information age? Now, people going to say, man, look, how can Big Meech be the feds when he's serving the rest of his life in the can, man? Look, there's plenty of people that got caught out there. Just because you working with the feds don't mean you can't do no time. There's plenty of police officers that got caught up and got to take some time for the team, man. There's plenty of undercover cops that get mixed up and wind up having to serve some time if they don't follow protocol. I don't know what to think about this situation, but I would imagine that if these dudes was all working for the feds, that explains why more than half of BMF is on the streets. And not only are these dudes on the streets, they're telling their stories as if there's no consequences or repercussions for what they did. They like rock stars in the ghetto. These dudes pull up to the gas station in the new freaking Benz. Everybody know you was down with BMF because you did about 15 documentaries talking about what y'all did, how y'all did it, and when y'all did it. And you out on the streets to talk about it? These fools is making movies, making albums, talking about the drug trade and what they did on the block. And they able to go get a two-piece in the biscuit? I'm just not understanding what type of deal these dudes made in order to be the most infamous, most kid-friendly drug cartel in the U.S. of A history. They about to make a Disney movie about these dudes, man. They gonna have Mickey Mouse with some braids playing Big Meech. They gonna have Goofy with some baggy jeans on playing Young Jeezy. These dudes is kid friendly as if they never even harmed nobody. So y'all gonna have to figure this out, man. But Big Meech, man, if you listening, people been asking questions about you in the streets, man. And I know it's not good to test your gangster, cause you got a million dudes, a million hitters out there ready to do anything that you tell them to do, Meech. You got dudes in Detroit that worship you. You got dudes in Atlanta that look at you like a god. I know Big Meech not the dude to play with. I know Young Jeezy ain't the dude to play with. I know none of these dudes ain't no laughing matter. But if I know about you selling dope, and everybody watching this video know about you selling dope before you got caught selling dope, we knew what BMF was doing before they even got arrested one time. So you mean to tell me it's public knowledge that y'all dudes moving weight, but the feds don't know? I believe they was working with the feds the whole time. It only makes sense. If you can't keep a secret from some dude in the projects or some little old lady, anybody can see that these dudes were selling dope. A blind man could see that these dudes was moving narcotics, but they want us to believe that the feds didn't find out till later. What type of police force do they think is out there? The Mickey Mouse Club? One day they ran into Cinderella and it was over? It don't make no sense to me. Of course the feds knew what they was doing. That's because them niggas is the feds. I'm talking about all them dudes that's out on the streets right now to tell their story was working with the feds and still is working with the feds. But this is all alleged information, man. I can't speak on these people. I never met none of these dudes. I can't be speaking on them like that. But I'm just going off of my logic. And if I have a dumb logic, or stupid logic, please leave a comment in the comment section. To hell with the live chat. TB is in the building. She said the plug is the feds. Exactly, TB. Y'all seen the show Snowfall? The plug is the feds. And they was getting arrested so many times, getting pulled over, police asking questions and stuff. They was untouchable because the big dogs had them on the leash. When it was time to blow the thing up, when they don't acquired X amount of dollars, they're like, okay, man, we're going to have to blow this thing up. We're going to have to create this little bogus case to shut these dudes down for a little while. Get everybody new IDs, new identities. The have not, the people on the lower end of the spectrum, we can just put them out on the streets. They're going to be superstars and heroes. As far as the big dogs, they're just going to have to get a whole makeover. That street life, I'm in these streets because I be living that street life. I give y'all the documentations every night. If you subscribe to the channel, you gon' be aight.